Hello students, we are going to study about basics of crossbar system. In the earlier days, one person to another persons were actually connected by using manual operator. Those manual operators were replaced by the relays, so which were very uneconomic. A scientist named G.A. Bittelander around 1917 invented a crossbar switch. With the assistance of that, so we have matrix of cross points, so which is shown in the figure. So how this matrix of cross point will be working will be explained in the diagram itself. It has M inlets and N outlets. Both are connected at one point. So because they are connected crossly, so they are called crossbar system, which were operated by two magnet. One magnet which will be operated in the vertical side, and another magnet will be operated in the horizontal side. The horizontal magnet is named as select magnet. The vertical magnet is actually called bridge magnet. How this will be working? It actually worked on the magnetism. Whenever any persons want to communicate with another person, this cross point have to be connected. First, we shall just go through the select magnet. The select magnet will go up and down. So you can see the separation. So this is actually separated, which will be going up and down. That means, so if this is down means it is connected, up means it is released. And bridge magnet will be always connected to the line. Suppose we'll assume this second line, that means this point have to be connected, means this horizontal magnet and this vertical magnet have to work. First, the select magnet will go down. Then afterwards, all these bridge magnet will be connected. So which line is to be connected, that magnet has to be connected to the particular line. That means this point is connected. These type of the connections are actually economic way of connecting the customers. So these are used. So this point is actually called matrix of crossbar system. This actually show the 3D view of a crossbar system. So where you can see select magnet and how the mechanism works. So which is actually shown in the 3D diagram. This is marker control of a crossbar switch. Crossbar switch is not an intelligent system. You may be surprising how the point exactly the line will be selected. That actually depend on the marker control. In the diagram you can see how the lines are connected. We have a register and we have a marker control. The lines actually started from 1 to 0 and here also we have 1 to 0. And how the lines are connected, that depend on this line. So this line is actually connected to the next switching center. So this is actually called a Strager selector, which will be actually counting the number of lines and searching which line has to be connected to the next exchange. For that purpose, crossbar switch is not an intelligent system. Marker system will actually do everything. The magnet, the select magnet and the bridge magnet work based on the marker. Suppose assume that here one line is connected. The horizontal line is coming from 3 and the vertical line is 6. So these two lines are actually marked by the marker and these lines are stored in the register. In this way, the line are connected. So this shows that marker is an intelligent system. So slight current actually flows through this. So it will connect the third line to the sixth line. You'll get most expected question in the question paper to explain two stage link network. In the earlier we shown a crossbar system. A crossbar switch has a capacity to connect 10 switch to another 10 switch. It can be used in place of two motion selector also. If you want to have number of connections which will be connected to the exchange, you need to increase the group of selector. Here we have selected two stage link network. It is shown in the diagram. This side is actually called A stage, B stage, which is connected with the links. Suppose assume that I need to connect 100 incoming trunks to 100 outgoing trunks. I need minimum 10 switches on primary side and minimum another 10 switches on the secondary side. How to connect from one switch to another switch, it is actually shown in the diagram. In the earlier we known that the crossbar switching system numbers from 1 to 0. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 is replaced with 0. 10 switches on this side, 10 switches on this side. And each actually numbered in the same way. 1 to 10 links, 1 to 10. How the connections has to be connected means clearly observe. I am starting from switch number 1. From switch number 1, from 1 to 1 of the switch. From 2 to 1, from 3 to 1, and from 10 to 1 of the switch. Again, it will be clear if you observe the second switch. So clearly observe here. This is second switch number. I'll be starting from switch number 1. 1 is connected to 2. 2 is connected to 2. 3 is connected to 2. 10 is connected to 2. To clear it, so if you have 2 stage network, we need 10 cross 10 switches. This is shown. And we need 100 links for the connection. The link number is actually represented on the diagram itself. For example, on the diagram, link 23 is mentioned. How this is mentioned means link 23 actually connect outlet of 3 primary switch. See here, outlet of 3 primary switch to the switch 2. So here we have switch 2 and 3 is the inlet of switch 3. Like this you can explain any link number. If you want to increase number of connections, you need to increase number of the switches. Suppose here using 10 cross 10 we have 100 incoming connections and 100 outgoing connections. Suppose you need to increase many number of connection means we have a connection called concentrator where you are going to connect many number of links. You can observe this in this diagram. Observe here, this concentrator is actually connecting 500 incoming lines. How these 500 incoming lines are possible means, this side we have the same thing. 10 secondary switches with 10 each at a line. And this side, you need to increase 100 incoming lines to 500 incoming lines. How this is possible means, in the previous two stage network, we have single crossbar switch. But here this is increased with 5 crossbar switch. That means, so 10 into 5, you'll be having 50 links. 50 into 10 means you'll be having 500 links. In this way, you can increase number of subscribers which will be connected to the exchange. Again, we have a highest exchange, that is 4 stage network, where you can connect 1000 incoming trunks to 1000 outgoing trunks using 10 cross 10 switches. Observe here, so we observed this in the previous line, that means 2 stage link network. This is 1 2 stage link network. Like that you have 10 2 stage network, that means 10 into 100 you will be getting 1000 incoming line. Similarly here also outgoing frames are the same thing. This is A stage network, B stage network, C stage network. 1000 incoming lines which are connected to 1000 outgoing lines, so with the help of 1000 links. Now we are going to study electronic switching. We started with the advancement of stored program control which is used in message switching. And when we want to connect one point to another point, we started with manual operator. Manual operators were replaced with relays which were uneconomic. And those were replaced by the matrix of crossbar system, that is crossbar switch. But still we need some higher end system which will provide some facilities to the customers. Those facilities are not provided by the earlier days electromechanical switches. So first what we'll do before understanding what is electronic switching, we'll just go through what are all the facilities so which the customers can follow or the customers can control by themselves. We have list of these calls. These were actually not provided in the landline phones, but you may be aware because you are using nowadays mobile system. We'll be listed 6 facilities which will be controlled by the customer itself. First, we shall go through call bearing. What is call bearing means? The customers may actually restrict unauthorized calls. Suppose assume that you are getting call from a customer calls or something restricted calls you don't want to receive. You can just avoid those calls. So that is actually call bearing. And repeat last call. If I used olden days landline, you'll be having one button called redial, which you'll press, you'll get the redial of the last number. That is repeat last call. Next, afterwards it is reminder call. Reminder call is nothing but a wake up call, or you may be having a reminder giving for an event, or monitoring a call, wake up call, so remembering a birthdays, so whatever it may be, it is remembering a call. Then afterwards, call diversion. In 2 days, everyone will be knowing what is call diversion, how to divert a call. Suppose you are not using the earlier phone number, you can have a call diversion by using call diverter. And afterwards, three-way calls. So this word may be new to you, but nowadays you'll be having conference calls. These three-way calls are nothing but the conference calls. For example, if two persons are communicating, if third persons want to communicate, he can communicate. That is three-way calls. And the last one is a charge advice. What is charge advice means? So in the earlier days, if two persons want to communicate, they need to give instruction to the operator. The operator will connect two persons, and he'll get information when the call is actually up, how many minutes they'll talk. That charge will be actually monitored in the exchange. That is actually called charge advice. All these may not be provided by the crossbar system. We are moving from electromechanical system to electronic system. So that is actually shown in the diagram, electronics way, which is actually renamed as diode cross point. In the earlier crossbar system, at each cross point, those were actually operated by the magnet, but those magnets were be replaced by the diode cross point. Actually, it is not a diode, so it is actually constructed using a transformer with one point grounded and another point which is actually connected to A. Depending on the position of the A, the communication line will be connected or disconnected. We'll be observing this point A. If point A is positive, means it will be reverse biased. I hope you know what happens whenever the diode is forward or reverse biased. Forward bias means it conduct. Reverse bias means it doesn't conduct. That means it will be disconnected from the communication system. According to the point A, if point A becomes positive, means it is reverse bias. That means there is no connection between the system. If the point A is negative, means it is forward bias. That means one line is connected to the other point. That means what is needed at this point means, if you want to get connected with one line to other line, you need to maintain this A point to be negative. You need some external circuit so that it can maintain your point A to be negative. So it means that, so you are connected to the next switching system. So for that purpose, so we need a crossbar switch which have a memory with a finger trapped in the cross point which will be operated. And research has actually carried out some functions which will be dependent on single equipment, because you need one point to store a number and you need another component which will be keeping your A point at the negative point. So that point may be used, what are the components used at this point means, it may be cold cathode gas tubes or PNPN semiconductor devices which have been used. So these are used as a single component for a storage devices at a diode cross point system. And at the last, so you can be having an FDS system, that means frequency division multiplexing system, which could be used in earlier days. And switching system may be classified as the last one as a space division and time division, that may be explained in the further chapters. Thank you.